There's such an honest truth when it comes to shooting film photos that that's what originally gravitated me towards it. It wasn't the highest quality stuff. It was about being a human and documenting the things that you really cared about.
All of the magic and all of the foundational stuff of working together and with that beautiful team all started and these things happened. G really put a lot of trust in me about like making sure that everything was always at the highest quality.
My name is John Lewag, and I'm a photographer and creative director from Valencia, California, and this is my cover story. Honestly, I grew up playing sports, and me even being an artistic or creative person was never really in the sphere of what I did. I was really driven to find out what I was passionate about, and music and fashion and these things that I was seeing online were really, really inspiring to me.
I started as a journalism and graphic design major in college. I was inspired the most by cover art, inspired by fashion, inspired by posters, tour posters and merch and things like that.
The day that I quit my job and the day that I walked out of school, I didn't wake up that morning knowing I was gonna do it. Throughout the day as it developed, it was just more and more recurring thoughts of like, I could do this on my own. I didn't have a plan, I didn't have any clients, I didn't have a camera, I didn't even have a really functioning computer. What I wanna do with all of my stuff is to be as DIY and as normal and regular and accessible as possible. But it's just because I want people to know that they can express themselves or document their lives in this way that feels really magical, but it's not that far away.
When it comes to photography and my creativity, it stemmed from a place of wanting to document my actual life. So this is my go-to digital camera. This is a Sony a7S II with a 24-70 2.8. This is my favorite camera of all time, Contax T2. Literally, you just turn it on and then you shoot. I love the delayed gratification about it the most.
I feel like photography was this very natural thing for me, and I feel like graphic design was very much a learned trade. And I think I kept following the things that I was inspired by from a craft point of view, that I would take a deep dive of what it means to be an illustrator, what it means to be a letterer, what it means to be a video editor. Working with the G-Eazy team, I realized looking back at the era, it was the best creative team I could have asked for. And the person that's like above the rest that I think I respect him so much as an artist and as a director and photographer is Bobby Bruderle, who shot all of G's covers for the albums that I worked on. Hey, Bob.
Yo,
nice to see you, man. We were just talking about the G-Eazy covers and all the stuff in that era. I feel like we worked pretty closely for like 5-6 years.
It's crazy that, you know, all those albums became as big as they did and that, you know, we were able to maintain a thread for as long as we did, because that's pretty rare in the album art world. That pressure at that stage in our careers was definitely a good thing. And I think that's what's so amazing about it, is the fact that we were able to experience so much and go through so many wild times together and be on the same page creatively. It's just, you know, it just doesn't happen very often.
The way that G and I met was because I was a journalism and graphic design major in school. In the journalism program, they wanted me to intern for a local newspaper. Hated that. I walked out on my first day. Graphic design, it just didn't match the taste level of the things that I was inspired by at the time. And so in order to challenge myself to know that I could really do this, I wanted to merge both of those two things, and then I came up with a magazine. And then after like 3 months of so much work, I had this like physical representation of something that was like my product 100%. And I documented the whole thing on Twitter, but then like three people cared. It was like my two best friends and then this random rapper named Gerald. He saw everything that I put into it and was like, oh my gosh, wait. Do you do websites? I'm going on the biggest tour of my life, Vans Warped Tour. And then he asked me, do I do merch? And I hadn't, but then I was like, yes. And then when we got signed to a label, it was like, okay, now this is serious stuff. This is like album packagings, in-store installations. To have been there from like a very, very early like grassroots time where it was like no budget, and then seeing it on a massive scale, it was like there's no better way to work with an artist and then also learn all of the ropes of the industry. G really put a lot of trust in me about like making sure that everything was always at the highest quality.
After I did the website, the next thing was a new project and a new tour, and that was associated with the Must Be Nice tour. Leading up to the first album and after that first mixtape, there was a period of time in the middle where he would just be uploading singles to SoundCloud. And there was a specific cover art style that we landed on. We used to reference it as like the fortune cookie type. This Far Alone cover with G-Eazy and J-Ant. E-40 wasn't on the song yet. The fonts that I chose for this led into overall G brand, including the movie credit look at the bottom of these covers. I think collectively within the team, we really cared about minimalism, really cared about creating iconic images and not really cluttering what could be a really busy canvas. We try to just remove as many elements as possible. All of the magic and all of the foundational stuff of working together and with that beautiful team all started in These Things Happen. It bled over so organically for the sophomore album, When It's Dark Out. Those two albums felt like we really refined exactly what we were doing. It was like, felt more filmic than anything we could have done. I credit the years that I shot only personal stuff of like my girlfriend at the time and my dog and just documenting what was around me. It wasn't really exciting subject matter, but it was really important to me, which kept the same ethos of all of the photography stuff that I was inspired by on Tumblr. All of the personal stuff that I shot really informs all of the way that I shoot now. Princess Nokia or Jessie Reyes, I could be in a room with anybody and just document their natural elegance and get a sense of their energy in the space because of all the personal stuff that I shot. Those years were really formative for the way that I hold a camera and shoot now. It's not professional at all, but it's so unique and specific to me. And if I can just tap in and be like, I'm just shooting my personal stuff, that's the bare minimum, and I'm really confident in that.